Hello and welcome to the Django ORM Mastery course, Level 1. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to view the SQL code for queries that return a query set. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to output the SQL code associated to all Django executed queries. If you find anything in this tutorial where I'm referring back to different tutorials, this tutorial is part of the Django Database ORM Mastery course. You will find the YouTube edition playlist in the video description so you can view from the very beginning. If you would prefer a more comprehensive step-by-step ad-free approach, then you can definitely check out our Udemy course, Django Database ORM Mastery. There is a link again in the video description, which will always give you the best price for this course. The actual course thumbnail may change over time, so just look for the name Database ORM Mastery, created by Very Academy. So don't forget we're using base code 1 here. If you haven't seen the setup guide for this section, then if you do want to follow along step by step, have a look at that first. So here we have the setup. Here I'm just continuing from the previous tutorial, so I may need to add a few different commands to remove some of the data that we inserted into the database, but that's no problem. We're just going to learn a little bit more. Right, so let me just exit here so we're all on the same page potentially. So if you follow the guidelines in the setup guide in this section, we should be right here. Now, from here, we are utilizing the terminal to access the Django project and work with the database. So we are typing in Python 3, manage.py, and then we're going into the shell. If you have come from the previous tutorial, you'll know that we've just added some data to the database. So once we're inside of the shell, let's go ahead and just access the brand table. These are just commands that we utilized in the previous section. So we're just going to copy and paste those in. So I've got a new file here called example.py. It's just going to make it easier for us to, for you to pause, copy them out if you would like to and follow along. So here I'm going to just access the brand table. It looks like I've got some data inside of my database. So I'm going to use the .delete command here to function to just remove all that so we can start fresh. And then I'll go ahead and, like we did in the previous tutorial, just go ahead and create a new item in the database. There we go. So we now have one item back in the database. Of course, we didn't need to do that, but the reason why we did do that is because Django behind the scenes is saving all of those SQL queries in a list and we can access them. For this to work, you will need to make sure that your project here in the settings is set to debug equals true. So just make sure that your project is set to true, otherwise this won't work. So let's bring in some new resources. So what we're going to do here, just drop that down a little bit. So from the django.db, we're going to import connection. So this is going to provide us, connection.query is going to provide us the list of all the queries. And then we will also import the reset queries, because what we can do is we can reset, we can remove all those stored SQL statements and start again. So remember, we are using the terminal here, so we are going to need to import that in so that we have access to that in our terminal session here. So I'm just going to clear that, Command and K on the Mac. Right, so we have those resources now, they're ready. So to access the queries, it's really simple. So let's just type in connection.queries. And there we go. So here's a list of all the different queries, and you can see that we have this SQL text here, which is indicating a new SQL statement. And you can see that there's a few here that we have or that we've already run. So you can see we've selected from the brand table all the items from the brand table. So we did a select all. It looks like we've now initiated a select from. So it looks like we've initiated another select all from brand table. And you can go ahead and read all this SQL and it can give you a good indication of what SQL has actually been executed. But like I said, we can reset them. So this is the command right here, reset queries. So if I go ahead and run this command, which you cannot see because I've gone too far down. Apologies. So just here. Apologies. So if you didn't see the previous command, it was connections.queries that I run. Apologies. I keep forgetting about that. So what we're doing here, then, we're running reset queries. Don't forget the parentheses, and that will then reset that list. So if I then inspect the queries again, you can see that we have an empty list. Okay, so what I can do now is just run the brand objects all again to return all the brand items in the brand table. And then let's run the connection queries again. And you can now see that it has just one query. So now we returned an empty list. Let's remember that in the previous tutorial where we are utilizing .query, it wasn't returning queries for functions that didn't return query sets. So let's just highlight the fact that this method will return those SQL queries or will give us some SQL information. So where is what we saw in the previous tutorial, the .query attribute would only return SQL related to methods that return new query sets. Here we're going to now see that utilizing this method, we can return SQL from both query sets, methods that return query sets, and methods that do not return new query sets. So let's just make sure that everything is deleted to begin with. So we'll just do a brand delete, and that would delete all the data in the brand table. And we'll just then do a reset queries. And then we'll go ahead and we'll utilize the create. So create does not return a new query set. So the dot query would not work in this instance. So let's go ahead and run this. And now let's go ahead and just inspect. So connection dot queries. And we can now see that we can return the SQL for that particular operation. Hello and welcome to the Django ORM Mastery course, level 1.